Hi, it's Laura from RSVPify, here to talk to you a little bit about the email builder. So right now I am in a shell of an event that I set up called Simple RSVP. You might imagine this looks something like your event. Let's head over to the email builder and create a new email. You'll notice here in this menu that you have under email, you have new email, drafts, scheduled, and sent. We'll talk a little bit more about what scheduled and sent means in just a minute. All right, when you populate a new email, the first thing I want to talk to you about is the theme itself, right? The colors that you're seeing, the text that you're seeing. This is all driven by the themes that you've set up in your form itself. You can change any of these by simply clicking around to customize it however you'd like. Email body background the same way. Accent bar, whether or not you'd like to have it, you can turn that on and off. You can add a logo if you'd like. You can click right into here to change the size, the font, right? You can add merge tags if you'd like to. Let's say that you are inviting somebody and you want to make this text, dear first name. So this would populate from your invite list. And then these here are the RSVP buttons. That's what we call them, the attending and can't make it. You can customize those as well. So you can change the text color, the button color, and then the radius. Notice what happens when I change the radius here. Let's make the button color something really bright so you can see it. Notice what happens as I move it down and up. It gets rounder. So that's what happens there. I'm going to make this button color back to black. That's the sleek look I'm going for. This is how you customize things. Again, you can add images if you'd like. Simply click, plus add a QR code, add a, like we said, merge tag, add the RSVP button, add an image, or change any of the formatting as you see fit. Now let's talk about the email subject real quick. By default, it's going to say you are invited to the name of the event. Change it to whatever you'd like. From RSVPify, that's the account that I'm under, but if I wanted to make it from Laura, I could do that. This section right here, it's an option available to our enterprise clients. It's called email white labeling. And basically what it allows is for me to send an email as though it looks like it's coming from my company. And the idea there is sometimes folks think that if it comes from their company, it fully embraces their brand and folks might be more likely to open it. So some people opt for that add-on in the enterprise plan. You can change this to anything that you'd like. I recommend it be your email or whoever is going to be responding to questions. Now let's talk about who this email is going to. You can choose whether it's everybody on your invite list, those who haven't replied, a custom audience, or selecting individual recipients. You can also schedule to send later, or send now. I like to draft all my emails in the very beginning and then schedule to send later. As you're scheduling and your RSVPs are coming in or you're adding more people to your invite list, those tallies will still count until the moment that the email is sent. So just because you schedule it now doesn't mean that you're not gonna get everyone who's been added to the list or to the event up until your email goes out. That's the basics of the email builder. If you have questions, you can reach us at the chat. We have a really great guide as well on our website, and which you can check out at our help library. Let me show you where to go. If you type in email builder, it should be the first thing that pops up. Hope this was helpful. Thank you for choosing RSVPify.